टोल्ड इन हिंदी, तेरे को आज ही आना था इधर, बिकॉज दैट एस्ट्रोलॉजर हिमसेल्फ इज मैरिड, ही हैज अ फैमिली. एंड व्हाट हैपेंड वाज, द फनी थिंग वाज, ही वेंट टू हिज होम बिफोर दिस क्लाइंट, एंड देन हिज वाइफ, अगेन अनदर वुमन, वाइफ सेड नो नो गो आउट, ही इज नॉट हियर, वुमन इज सेंडिंग यू बैक, अनदर क्लू, वुमन इज टेलिंग यू कैन नॉट एंटर, गो आउट, ही इज आउटसाइड, इधर नहीं है, बाहर है, जाओ बाहर. And then the other clue was when he went, it was like a group of males, all these males are sitting, and you know, they lagega tera. Without that only, he said. And he said, you come after, and because it is marriage, seventh house, he said, after come after 7 months. Because he calculated the lagna was sthira, so it's not days or weeks, it has to be months. Some calculation he did, of course. He said, okay, marriage hai na, 7 mahine baad aana. And then after 7 months, when he came, he again went to his home. That time he was available. And what happened is his younger daughter was kind of playing with him. And then he said that you will get married, and within he took note of the daughter's age. The daughter was 4 months, something like 4 years, sorry. And then he made another calculation that in after 4 months of marriage, your wife will conceive, something like this he told.
Deciphering the omens, right? That phase.
Yeah, that time he converted that seventh house, number seven to months.
Okay.
Because he was in a place of Mars, masculinity.
Okay.
So there's no place for water to enter there.
Right, emotions to enter.
It takes a long term to enter there. So he said 7 months, but maybe if Saturn would be involved, he would have said 7 years.
Possibly.
And he's such an expert, he already knows, okay, sun is here, it's the noon time, so lagna will be this, four signs. Then he knows where Saturn is. Then he might have calculated, oh, Saturn, is he linked to the ascendant or day or something like that, and he might have seen no. Then after the seventh month, on the seventh month again, he came, and then very soon he got married. And his wife also conceived, and they also had a baby. So yeah, the omens are very powerful indeed. Yeah, so he said the first symptom was my wife told you, go out, he's outside, not here.
One minus from there only.
Yeah, and that too, the he has 2-3 kids.
Okay.
So if the boy, the son would have told him, it would have been a different meaning. That would have meant that his childbirth would be delayed. He said. But because my wife told you, the wife is Venus, it's the lady telling you that go out, he's not here, go out. It's like Venus is going out from your life. So then he was not able to find, and then later on he found. So yeah, many, many things. So it's like women are crazy, very beautiful. In villages this happens.
Yes, yes.
And in fact, in villages they also say, not in villages, even in cities, they say, no, jhoot bole kawa kaate de.
Right.
So once what happened, one of my friend had come, it's not for villages, for everywhere it works, even here in Germany it works. And so one of my friend, he had come, and it was very weird something. I realized his left side, his left eye was not blinking.
Okay.
It was like really very weird. You know, his right eye is blinking, left eye is not blinking. As if he has had some paralysis or something like that. And then he came and he asked me some questions about his horoscope. And then I saw this crow.
Okay.
Crow was hovering around. Then I know definitely it is something to do with old age or disease or something.
Right.
So then he told he got a disease by which his left side is paralyzed, and 3 years is younger to me, unfortunately. So at this age only. So, but then, so that was an indication that because Saturn represents old age. Old age, what happens when you're old? You can't move. So old age is like a paralysis only.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So now he has undergone some partial paralysis or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And it was very interesting. He came to my home, and my home was in second floor, 204.
Mm-hmm.
204, sorry. Mm-hmm. And I don't know what happened to me. I said, what will you sit in home? Let's go outside. And then we went to the garden.
Mm-hmm.
Garden, we went and we sat there.
Mm-hmm.
And then I saw that garden is again what? It's green, right? Mercury is the another.
Mm-hmm.
Mercury is like pulling me there.
Mm-hmm.
And because it was around sunrise or around that morning time, Sun, Mercury were one, two houses away from each other as usual, of course. So Mercury was in the ascendant.
Mm-hmm.
And Mercury rules these nerves.
Right.
So he was having some problem in nerves and there was no communication and paralysis. Mm-hmm. Saturn was also very strong there.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes, I have seen these things happening all the time. Or sometimes, as in India also, they used to say, if somebody was about to go out,
mm-hmm.
then if the husband would go out and the wife would have a glass of milk and the milk would fall down, she would say, no, don't go. It's not auspicious.
Right.
Why did they say like that? Did you ever hear the water has fallen down? They say, don't go out.
I know. Actually, they what I can remember is they usually put a full glass of water or a full tumbler of water in front of the door. That is considered as an auspicious omen that you are going out, you will come back with the full thing. The farmers' houses, they do that whenever they go out to sell their harvest. You know, they put a full tumbler full of water. That represents the fullness, whatever you'll bring back home, that'll be, you'll get the total amount of your crops and total amount of your harvest. That much I remember. But this thing, I don't know.
Yeah, because, that water can also mean that maybe your sustenance is, continuing, mm-hmm. something like, or it increases. And that's why I have heard in different Vastu and Feng Shui systems also, they say a fountain is very good if it is placed in a particular direction. But regarding this milk, I was telling that why it is only with milk? Why not, with fruit juice or water or wine or alcohol or anything like that? Because milk is represented by the moon.
Mm-hmm.
So when milk has fallen down, it is like saying some mental or some family problem is coming, because of which the whole family is getting affected.
Okay.
So that is why they would say if that person would go out, maybe the person has a serious accident or the person dies or something like that. Because then the whole family is affected.
Okay.
Because the moon is the most important planet. It represents your overall happiness. So if that is only going down, then it is not considered to be a good omen in that case.
Okay.
Now, of course, it depends on so many other things also, because it is said in the scriptures, that the gods, the devatas will send you these omens actually.
Yes.
And to the degree you are elevated, you will see these omens. In fact, in Srimad Bhagavatam, it is very, very, very clearly mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
When Lord Krishna left this planet,
mm-hmm.
then Arjuna went, he did all the samskaras, and then he came back.
Mm-hmm.
And when he came back to Hastinapur, then Yudhishthir Maharaj saw him. He saw Arjuna's face, and Yudhishthir, he is Dharmaraj Yudhishthir after all. His kingdom and his rule is, that's the pinnacle of dharma.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine the level of omens which you can see if you are in his kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
And imagine if you are Yudhishthir yourself, what you can see.
Mm-hmm.
In the first canto, there's a detailed description what Yudhishthir Maharaj says. He says, Oh, Arjuna, it seems some calamity has dawned. I have heard the donkey's brain. And there are many other things which different versions say, you know, that this there are many inauspicious animals which make sound, you know, when something bad has happened. No, and he also says, I think that I see the clouds but no rains. Very, very, very bad omen that is. Clouds and no rains. And he gives a list of the omens that he sees. And then when Arjuna does not reply to any of these, then at the end he asks that, has Krishna left? Then when Arjuna says that, yes, Krishna has left, Yudhishthir Maharaj also departs. He does not call a meeting there. Hey, you know, actually, you bunch of intellectuals, please come. Let's decide who will be the next guy to sit there. You know, will it be my son, his son, your daughter, his daughter, whoever? I mean, son, daughter, granddaughter, grandson, whoever. Who will sit in the throne? No, nothing doing. He goes and he puts off his royal clothes. He takes white, he takes a sadhu vesh and he starts walking to the Himalayas. And the Pandavas, including Draupadi, they also follow him. So there's a long list of the omens which are mentioned. And these every animal is, as you know, nakshatra and animals, right? Every animal will kind of be a witness for a particular nakshatra. So if that animal is making sound, you know that somehow that nakshatra's themes will become activated. Like there was one consultation which I did. It was a lady, she was somewhere in France, I guess. And when I saw her in Skype, the background, her the wall, that was having snakes. Some snake drawing was there in that. So then I know snake means Rohini is involved in that. Something to do with seduction or love triangle or your spouse is stolen by somebody else. Something this some flavor like this was will be there, and that's what the consultation was about. And by chance, I also asked her, which color do you like the most? She of course ended up saying, I like red the most because Rohini is red. So yeah, the omens are very powerful. In fact, I always see if I do a video consultation, what the client is wearing. What the, I mean, I've seen this time and again. You wear the color of Saturn. You have had it. The consultation is very difficult. You are telling something the client is not satisfied. Because Saturn is influencing that client, you see. Person is not agreeing. Saturn is dissatisfaction. He's the Karaka for dissatisfaction. So if Saturn is involved, or if there are too many Saturnian things in that room also, I've seen, then your level of dissatisfaction will be very high. Not your, I mean the clients, which will end up getting transferred to you finally.
I'll also share one incident here. Once I was doing one consultation and I was thinking what all remedies should I give to that person, right? And we have a terrace here, and we hear those sounds of dogs barking and train coming and all, right? Then I was writing those remedies for that person, and suddenly I hear the sound of dogs barking. Then I included that remedy as if Mother Nature wants me to feed dogs, wants me to include that remedy of feeding dogs and all. Then I wrote that remedy. Then I am a strong believer of omens while writing remedies or while deciphering events for the people, positive or negative outcomes. That is there. Omens, they play a great part, indeed.
Yeah, in fact, this is not only with consultations or anything negative or bad, good. It's with every area of life, in fact, I've seen.
Right.
Yeah, I always remember this one exam when I was doing my master's here. I was well prepared, of course. But then when I took out my pen and I gave, it's not writing. I failed by 1 mark. I just failed that exam. So it always happens, I've seen. To the degree you are, actually, there's nothing called as omens. It's like very simple, you know, what the universe is trying to tell you.
Right.
The
right.
thing is, we are so much disconnected these days because of, you know, mobile and all these addictions, you know, all this. Like people tell me, you know, oh, there was a, like people think, you know, some very crazy thing has to happen. You know, only then that is a omen. Some very bad thing has to happen, or some great news you must hear. That's not true. Sometimes I have seen, I'm about to meet somebody, and then I'm kind of feeling a bit down, you know. And then the interaction is also not good. So it's as simple as that. You know, you are not feeling good, the interaction also is not good. It's as simple as that. I mean, I don't have to see a WhatsApp message like I told in case of that other person to see, you know, that he has had a fight with his girlfriend. I don't have to see a WhatsApp message. But the problem is we are only so much disconnected from nature, from our own self, you know, our own mind and the externals.
Right. We need to be more aware to see those omens, to connect with those things, right?
Yes. Otherwise, it's like many times people say, you know, that sometimes people, their parents, they call me and tell that, oh, can you please explain this to my son, to my daughter, you know? And then I hear, okay, what should I explain? And they say, oh, can you tell them that you should do this and not this? And then I'm like, okay, this is a matter of common sense. This neither the parent needs to tell on, neither do I need to tell on nobody else. But because that child is so much disconnected because of, you know, eating all this sugar, you know, all this non-vegetarian food, TV, Instagram, Facebook. Person is the boy or that small girl is not aware only what is going on. Correct. And then you come and hammer, you know, the rule says this is not good. And then they're like, why are you lecturing me on rules, man? I just want to play using my iPad. Who the hell are you to tell me what should I do? And then I'm like, yeah, if you only don't know, then who the hell am I to tell you what you should do?
Right.
So I mean, it's very simple. The more you are aware, the more you will be able to see the things which are already there, actually.
Yeah, true.
And here is the thing about what is intuition. Many times people say intuition is like, sometimes I've seen it's very overrated sometimes. Like, many times I see people, they tell me, oh, okay, I need a consultation on my marriage. I think I will have a divorce. You know, my intuition says I will have a divorce. And I'm like, okay, how do you come to that conclusion? So many times people, intuition is good provided you are aware at a certain level. Otherwise, it's the voice of your mind, nothing else. But today my mind says I will get this, I will be happy. Tomorrow my mind says, what is that? See, he has a better thing. So the mind is very subjective.
Right.
So my guru used to say that if you are not aware spiritually, then that is not intuition actually. Many times people say, mere andar se ye voice aa raha hai. I'm getting this voice. Is it my mind's voice or is it God's voice? How do I know that? So, yeah, I also had once asked one of my gurus, and he said, it's very clear how to know if it's your whimsical mind suggesting or is it God who is suggesting. It's very easy. If the suggestion matches with what is there in the scriptures, it is the suggestion, it is the voice of God. If it is not matching, it is your whimsical, loose mind, which is the suggesting things which can always keep varying.
Right.
So intuition and all this is good. It can be used and it should be used.
Mm-hmm.
But that is good only after you have reached a certain level of, I would say, spiritual maturity, when you are able to apply the teachings of the scriptures in your life.
Right.
Only after that, otherwise it can be your voice of the mind. And the mind is, as Bhagavatam says, you know, manorathe nasati dhavato vai. Today, mind goes in the chariot, you know. Like a driverless chariot, you know, wherever you want, you go. You know, people have this experience during meditation.
Right.
Then they say, oh, meditation, we will control the mind using meditation. But then the moment they start to meditate, the mind is like going haywire, crazy.
Right.
Mind is going to this place, meeting that person. All the anarthas are coming up. The six anartha, lust is coming up, greed is coming up, and it creates a lot of mess sometimes. Therefore, spiritual awareness has to be there, because of which you can actually be rested. You can actually be assured that, yes, this is what God wants me to do now. What God is trying to tell me.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, anybody can tell me tomorrow, my intuition says, you know, I should go and kill this person. They can say that.
Mm-hmm.
But that is not what any sane man will suggest to you, right? That you should go and kill someone.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, the omens are very good and intuition is also very good. Along with that, we should cultivate our self spiritually also.
Right.
Only then we know it is actually an omen.
Right.
Otherwise, it can be like just another thing happening.
Mm-hmm.
So we may be hyper cautious. You know? Anything happens, it is an omen from the gods. You know, speaking through. You know, tomorrow suppose you are sitting and you know the light goes off. And, oh my God, what will happen? My bank balance will go off or something like that. So, but that's the tricky thing. You know? When something happens which actually is an omen, to understand for that particular situation.
Right.
That is actually the art of omens.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else, or should we go to the examples?
We'll move to examples now. Yeah.
Okay. So then I will share my screen. Can you see the screen?
Yes, I can see a blue screen. Yes, clouds, I feel.
Okay. Can you see this chart?
Yes, I can see. Oh, Cancer rising.
I will try to zoom this.
Yeah, perfect.
Visible, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so this person had asked me a question. When will I get a job?
Okay.
And this person was unemployed.
Mm-hmm.
And the person was asking me, why am I not able to get a job? So now let us try to analyze. So as I said, it is a Thursday.
Guru.
Mm-hmm. UR is written Thursday. It is after sunrise. So it is actually Thursday, Vedic Thursday. Mm. Then we see Jupiter.
Mm.
Jupiter is ruling which house? Sixth house. And the ninth house.
Yes.
Mm. There you go. Job, Lord.
Mm.
The moon trikon is Sagittarius.
Mm.
So it is actually pertaining to job.
Mm.
Now, job and the ninth house.
Mm.
And then this Jupiter is placed in the fifth house.
Mm.
And it is retrograde if you see here.
Yes.
Okay, and it is about to go into the Gandanta zone, 29 degrees Scorpio.
Correct.
Okay.
That
means a major transformation is coming up.
Okay.
Which this person is kind of most probably not aware of, most of the cases I have seen. When Gandanta is about to come, you are not aware. That's why it's called Gandanta, of course.
Yes.
So, when now we know the agenda and why is it ruling the ninth house? Because the person has been doing masters and is abroad actually.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, the ninth house shows higher education.
Mm.
And now here, this Jupiter is placed in trines. It is in the fifth house.
Mm.
And the trines, as I said, in general, it's a very good placement.
Mm.
So then when you know sixth house, then you can check the Karakas like Saturn and Mars, where they are placed. Saturn is also here in the sixth house and Mars, okay, not very good in the. But because it is a question related to career, we also need to check the 10th house and we also need to check the Karakas for the 10th house also because it's a career question.
Mm-hmm.
So here we see Mercury is placed in the 10th house itself. Fantastic. And Sun is exalted. It is in the 10th house in Big Ball. Very good. The 10th Lord again is Mars. It is in the 12th. So this can mean either two things. Either you are losing your job. Or you are going abroad.
Mm.
Okay. And therefore, I told him, and if you see the Ascendant is Cancer.
It's again in 12th. Mm.
Yeah, it's a movable ascendant.
Mm.
But the Lagnesh is again in 12th. You see, so Lagnesh and the 10th is conjunct in the 12th house, in the Rahu Ketu axis.
Mm.
So the person is not only not having a job, he's also confused about which jobs to apply.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And if you see here, Moon is in Gemini, it is in Punarvasu Nakshatra.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened was this person did bachelor's in a particular domain and then he worked in a particular domain
mm-hmm.
for 2 years, 3 years, and then he went abroad for his master's.
Mm-hmm.
So now he is wondering, this Punarvasu thing is playing out here, he is wondering if the job which he applies should be in line with his bachelor's and master's or the work which he did 3 years.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so he's thinking which domain should I go back to.
Mm-hmm.
Now somebody may say that, oh, you have done master's, so why not continue that? But if you don't get a job, then because of that 3 year experience, you might get a job even if the domain is different. Sometimes it happens like that.
Mm-hmm.
So now the thing is, this 10th Lord is involved, so it is the work, you see. So this person is likely to continue the work which he was doing, not his master's. That's something very interesting, which we can see here. And this Guru is aspecting the Lagna, so this person is very positive.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
And because it's a chara rashi, movable sign, so
you can expect results sooner. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then I said when Mars touches Cancer,
mm-hmm.
okay, which is like Mars is in 1 degree of Gemini,
mm-hmm.
which is Mrigashira. Mrigashira means Mrigashira is the deer who is going on searching things, so he is searching, and this also means that when Mars would have touched this Cancer,
mm-hmm.
which is the ascendant, or Mars would have entered Leo, then only the job is possible, not before that.
Exactly. Mm.
And somehow Jupiter also has to be associated. Now you see the problem here is when this Mars will go here,
deputation. Mm.
Jupiter will be crossing up to Sagittarius.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
Now suppose Jupiter has 1 degree,
mm-hmm.
So if Jupiter is going very fast and before Mars reaches this Cancer, which because Mars takes 45 days, so 1 degree will roughly take 1.5, 2 days, so 43 days more for Mars to reach Cancer. But suppose before 43 days, Jupiter goes and aspects this Mars, because Jupiter from 6th will aspect the 12th.
Right.
And in that case, then it could happen that the person gets the job, but he does not get the offer letter. Yeah, and then when this Mars finally touches Cancer, he can get. But now here is the catch actually. You see, because this Mars has gone to debility as the 10th lord. So debility means there has to be some kind of a compromise always. So that means in some area of life he has to make some compromise. Now, how do you identify what area that can be? Well, you have to check the houses which also Mars rules. So Mars also rules the 5th house. So it's like saying his education has been totally wasted. Because he's ultimately going to work in a sector which is not linked to his master. So why the hell did you do the masters if you have to change your line? So now if you don't compromise that and you do if you follow the master's journey, then your 10th house, which is your earlier job, gets wasted. So now these two houses are such that because Mars rules both, so one of them will go. No, and Jupiter is also sitting, which is also the 9th lord. So it appears to me that his masters will almost, you could say, it will go wasted, and he will end up doing something which he did during his job 3 years back. And that is what he did when he got the job. He, of course, now he's trying to merge both. He's trying to bring things from his masters and then combine from what he got from his job also. And because this Mars is also the 10th lord, so therefore we could say that currently whatever you get, you accept it because it is in debility. Later on, now let's take current day scenario. Currently, Mars is going to enter Capricorn, right? After Sunday.
Yes.
So then, now of course, this person didn't contact me after that. But suppose this person would contact me, I would have told him that after 2 weeks around, when Mars, 2 weeks or 3 weeks, when Mars enters Capricorn, you can try for a promotion, and it's like 1 year almost. You see, May and June around, not 1 year, around 9 months. It could happen that time you could get a promotion after, till the time Mars stays in Capricorn, which is for the next 2 months. So this is when, if the person would come to me later. But this person got the job quite early only. In fact, this person got the job when Jupiter had entered Sagittarius, and Jupiter was in Gandhanta. Again, that 0 degree of Sagittarius. And it was still aspecting Mars. And as up to my expectation, the job was not very satisfactory. But he said, I have family responsibilities. So I took it. The second lord sun is in the 10th house. You see, that is the main concern. Now suppose this would be a Leo Lagna, it would have taken a long time. So, and apart from that, you can always check where Saturn is placed, because Saturn is the Karaka for the Dasamsa chart. That can show how much labor the person wants to do. So Saturn is in 6th, which is a good placement, so he's ready to do full labor. But the only problem is it's in Rahu Ketu axis, so he doesn't know where to labor. Confusing basically for him.
Right.
And because the Lagnesh is involved with this, he's He's not able to sleep. He's under anxiety, as I told you in the beginning.
Right.
Lagna is involved, which means you are in anxiety always, if it is badly afflicted.
Right.
And moon is also not in a very good sign, for the moon. Gemini, of course.
Right.
The only planet which does great in Gemini is Rahu.
Right. And here if we see, the Karesh becomes the sixth lord, 9, Sagittarius. And it is in the Scorpio. As soon as Jupiter comes to 6 and makes a connection with Lagna, the chances of job increases, right? Because Karesh and Lagnesh is making a sambandh.
Exactly. Jupiter and Moon.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is how you can say. Now, this was a bit easy, I would say.
Right.
But this one, which I was... Oh, yeah, one thing I forgot to show you. This is the same chart. Again, I have opened. This is again 9, you see.
Right.
9 is again numerology-wise, it is Mars. So Mars is again in the 12, again in the enemy sign of Mercury in this Rahu Ketu axis, aspected by Saturn. Very difficult.
Correct. Right.
It's a very crazy thing which is going on.
Mm-hmm.
Now, luckily, this Jupiter is well placed.
Mm-hmm.
And because it is retrograde, he had to change something. You know, he went to a different domain again, which he was doing during his job. So his master's kind of, you know, got like not very useful.
Right.
Okay, so now we go to this chart. Or should we open the marriage chart first? Okay, let us open marriage.
Okay. 20th September. Okay.
I think things are so if you follow the standard quotes here, you will see it's Friday.
Correct.
So Friday means it is Venus. So it is again Friday by sunrise. So this Venus goes to the Venus Lord 7th, my God. Second and 7th, you see, direct marriage. It is like, can't get better than this. And I don't know which part of the world, this is the chart of an Indian. So he must be in India and September, 3.5 hours difference. So that would be around 5:45 or something like this PM in India. So Venus Lord 2nd house, 7th house. So question, I can only predict the question is pertaining to marriage and family. Now, what are the resources Venus has? It's a precarious situation for Venus.
Venus is in Virgo.
Yeah, he's in debility in Maran Karakstan. In the 6th house, it is like very challenging for Venus. Then now of course again 20 is the day ruled by 2 is like moon. So moon is exalted here, it's in Taurus. He's thinking about family always. So now because of this exaltation of moon, the help, the good thing which is happening to him is that he will be able to accept the proposals earlier, you know, not too much picky and choosy and like not going on rejecting people all the time. Because he's very much interested to start a family with somebody. So now if you check properly, again there you see Uranus in the Lagna. So now if you check carefully, this is again Chara Lagna, Aries. So now what would you predict that because it's a Chara Lagna, there will be change and he will get married very easily. Actually, what happened? He got so frustrated, he decided he will not marry him.
Okay.
Said I am frustrated from last 5 years. I have lost everything in my life because of this. Do help you. Did you see that Uranus? Saturn. Mm-hmm. Uranus is like Saturn. It's Ashwini. You see the Lagna is Ashwini.
Mm-hmm.
Saturn. And sometimes we need to check the degree also. So Venus is in 13 degree, which is more than the ascendant degree, 6 degrees.
Mm.
So it is actually in the 6th house, not in the 5th house, as per Bhav Chabi.
Mm.
Now if you check the 6th house, again I said the Day Lord and the planets conjunct the Day Lord, if you remember, I said. Mm. So you see what is happening. Who is conjunct Venus here? Mercury, the 6th Lord. That adds to the problem more. And then this third lord is also there. So he's been doing this communications back and forth. And somehow not happening. And the fifth house son is the fifth lord. He's, you know, trying to find somebody whom he first likes or, you know, with whom he's obsessed or infatuated with.
Mm.
But the predicament is this planet of Brahmacharya is in his fifth house, Mars.
Mm-hmm.
So somehow it's like not happening. And as I told you earlier also, the trinal lords will tell you.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The trinal lords, if you see again, the trines, not a very good shape. Malefic in fifth, two malefic, my God, how many are there? Pluto, Saturn, Ketu.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, even if you ignore Pluto, there are again two malefics there. So is he getting any help from the Pitrus or from the ancestors? It doesn't seem like that. And then you check where is the fifth lord. Fifth lord is in Adusthana, son.
Mm.
Jupiter, the ninth lord, is again in Adusthana.
Mm.
And even if you take a traditional marriage, Jupiter is again the Karaka for the seventh house. It is again in Adusthana here. So things don't seem to be very good for this person. And then after some time, and he decided that he will not get married. And now you could always say, oh, wait, when Venus comes in seventh. But that will only happen if the overall prasna chart is positive. You know, just by the entry of Venus in seventh, you can't get married.
No.
Mm-hmm. And so everybody will say, oh, anyways, my planet will enter that prasna charts, this house, one day I'll get married. No. Mm-hmm. Like in case of career, we saw there were positive things. And mm-hmm. when that transit happened, then it happened. But here, if the horoscope is denying,
mm-hmm.
it is very difficult for it mm-hmm. to happen.
Right.
And if you see here, the Lagnesh is Mars.
Mm-hmm.
The Lagnesh is in Uttara Falguni, which is all to do with marriage.
Mm-hmm. Falgunis are like Purva and Uttara yeah. marriage ceremonies.
Uttara Falguni only marriage. They just entered Uttara Falguni. Just see. So that means if it would be in Purva Falguni, he would be in this hangover of marriage. Purva Falguni is the hangover, you know. Oh, I will have this perfect romantic marriage one day. That's Purva Falguni.
Mm-hmm.
Uttar Falguni is like, hold on, man, will I get married? So now he is not concerned with a happy married life anymore. He's only concerned, will he get married or not? And he is optimistic because it's in the fifth house. He is himself very optimistic.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to make the marriage happen. But because this Day Lord is in such a bad shape, it doesn't seem, and he has no help from the Pitrus or from the ancestors. And will remedies work? Trinal Lords badly placed, Jupiter badly placed, remedies will not work.
Mm-hmm.
So now the Chara Lagna is there. Okay, sudden change, Uranus, sudden. And if you know the story of Ashwini, it is the Ashwini Kumaras, you know, two together total.
Mm-hmm. twin theme.
It's like two men are together. So he's like, oh, better I stay with friends, you know, or do hell with all this marriage and all that. Doesn't happen. Yeah, so that's what he ended up doing finally. But he's somewhere in between. If you check, his moon is in Rohini, so he's still thinking of some red roses and he's in clouds to a large extent, moon being the numerology's day lord. So he's kind of in the junction. He wants a great marriage and now he's getting a feeling that maybe he will never get married. Mm-hmm. And now he comes to you to confirm.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Right, right.
Yeah, so that is okay from you, or anything else you would like to comment on this chart?
It's fine. But here one positive thing I can see, Jupiter and Moon again making a sambandh here. And he must be in a merry, merry sort of happy, happy mood at present when the question was asked that way.
Yeah, because if you also see, Jupiter is in Jyeshtha. So Jyeshtha Nakshatra at this trait, you need to get things done by hook or by crook. Like, any remedy, anything, you tell me, go to this Himalayas and head there 10 times, I will do it. Whatever it is you tell me, or you tell me you will not get married, either of the two. I don't want to be in this dilemma, oh yes, no, yes, no, all that. I'm done with this, either yes or no, just tell me. Yeah, I mean, if this Jupiter was well placed, then things could have changed. But there you see how this day lord works. Bang on. Two examples I had showed you.
Yes, yes, exactly.
Now, these were very direct examples. Now, let us check for this.
Wednesday.
Is the chart visible?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so here the person is born on a Wednesday and it is 17 July. 17th is the number of Saturn, it is 8. So whatever happens will be extreme. The trait of Saturn in numerology is extreme, either good extreme, bad extreme,
right?
So here if you check, Mercury is the day lord. Then Mercury is ruling which houses? He is lord of the 11th house.
And 8th.
And 8th.
Mm.
So this person had, this was a student, he was doing higher studies abroad. He asked me, he wants to continue his higher studies. Will he get some internship or some part-time job opportunity to continue his master's?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Because his father is not able to support him now.
Okay.
It's like 8th house is others' money, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
11th house is your money. 8th house is somebody else's money.
Mm-hmm.
So Mercury is ruling the 8th house. So you are concerned with your income, 11th house. It's not more of a job. It's more of that income stuff. You see, somehow I will sustain myself.
Mm-hmm.
And the 8th house, which means father is not able to sustain me. What should I do? So that means Mercury is primarily speaking for his own income. And then Mercury is placed in the 9th house with the 10th lord. Wow. Dharma Karmadhipati Yoga. Fantastic placement. Aspected by the 9th lord. So sorry, I mean not Dharma Karmadhipati Yoga is because of this sun and moon mutual aspect. Moon is the 9th lord. Sun is the 10th lord. So here it is again in the 9th house with this Lagna lord, Mangal.
Ascendant is also involved, yes.
Yeah, so this Jupiter is in the ascendant, so he's very positive, very hopeful, as I said, if natural benefic is in the ascendant. And The ascendant is out of any malefic influence or any malefic aspect or anything like that. Because Mars doesn't aspect, Saturn doesn't aspect, Ketu doesn't aspect, Rahu doesn't aspect, no malefic is aspecting. So inherently this person is not in depression. It is just a query which he has in mind, you understand? It is not that he's in anxiety, oh my God, what will happen? Okay, so this definitely means that maybe it is not such a big urgency for him. And yes, this Mars is in debility, so when the Lagnesh is in debility, I have seen you are ready to compromise on some of your principles. Because debility means, like debility can have many meanings, of course. One of the meanings is you are ready to break certain rules or regulations. Or it can mean you are ready to do something which you don't like. It can also mean that. This person was into mechanical engineering. And he was telling me, I just need to survive. So either I will find a part-time job or under my professor, or I will go and search job in Amazon and do all this, box lifting and all this. So he was like, I can also do things which I don't like because I need money at the end of the day. So he's not very concerned with what will happen to his status. Will he like it? Will he not like it? Because this Mars is in debility. Mars gets debilitated in Cancer. But because this Mercury is in the ninth involved in this Dharma Karmadhipati Yoga, therefore it is likely he will find a job very soon. And later on, when this person told me he had applied to this Amazon and he got a job there. And surprisingly, he was searching for these labor jobs, kind of picking boxes and doing all this, which gives the minimum wage. Then he got an IT job because he had some IT experience before, some front-end development job or something like that. Because if you see, Mercury is not alone. He's conjunct the 10th lord and the 6th lord. So that means his work experience will help him in getting this. He's getting his daily income. You see, your 6th house, 10th house shows work experience. So this is how you can suggest the person that you can ask him. Oh, you are doing masters. Okay, did you do some job before? Ah, applying that job. Definitely you will get it, but it's just that you may not like that very much.
And this person got the job within next month as soon as Mars moved to Leo.
Inquire this just recently, the person told me, yeah, it's good to inquire. Maybe I will ask him when that happened. But now he's about to finish his master's also. Now he will apply for the main job. This is just a matter of survival, actually. And because it is 17 Saturn, so it will either be in a very humble company or in a very big company. It's like very big, Amazon, huge. It will be like, one of the best places to go or one of the worst places. And here, there are many other things. You see, 5th lord is in the Lagna. Okay. 2nd lord is in the Lagna. So support of the family is there, but it's just that he doesn't want to use his father's money. Now, does it mean that his father will not give him money if he has? Definitely not like that, because that 2nd lord is in Lagna, so his father will support him. Yeah, so it is not that his father will never support him, but it's like he only doesn't want to take. He's like, oh, let me do it myself. Why should I take money from my father like this? Yeah, this is another very beautiful chart to illustrate Prashna chart. And but there is one catch here. It is a Sthira Lagna.
Yeah.
So it will take time to get the job. And there is, and of course, there are so many other things you can see. You know, Mercury is retrograde, Jupiter, Saturn are also retrograde. You can keep going on and on discussing.
And Moon is again in the Capricorn sign. He must be sort of a little worried or tensed also.
Yeah.
That
is pretty obvious, of course, because Moon is in Uttarashada.
Mm.
And Uttarashada has this trait, you know, he wants to be victorious finally. So yeah, this was our anxiety to some extent. So his situation was like, okay, I have been taking my father's money, I could still take, but I don't want to. So can I do without his money? And I said, yeah, of course, why not? You can do. But starts from your work experience. So he was an IT engineer before. Then he got an IT job. It's a bit weird. He's doing masters in a different domain, but his job is in IT, part-time job.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, later on, of course, now he's searching for the main job, actually, after finishing his masters. And here also, if you see, the trinal lords are relatively well placed. Moon is aspecting the ninth from there. Guru is in Lagna. Lagnesh is in ninth. Wow, fantastic. All trinal lords somehow linked with each other. Jupiter is also aspecting this Lagnesh. So very, very, very good placements.
Eleventh and ninth making a sambandh that way. Then eighth lord coming into ninth. That's
The only critical thing is he's facing severe issues in the family. Some family crisis is going on. That this Jupiter second lord is the dispositor of Ketu Saturn. So some unpleasant situation in the family, which has compelled him to come to get a reading, you see.
Possibly.
I mean, all these things are fine, Mercury and all this, but the ascendant will tell you what has actually, you know, like what has brought him to you. Or you could also see the day lord, you know, Mercury in ninth, something to do with the father. Sun, the Karaka for father, is also there with Mercury. Ninth lord, which shows the father aspect. So father is very strongly involved, you see.
Son is there, right? In the ninth.
This family issue has something to do with the mother, because Saturn is the fourth lord. So Rahu, the fourth lord, if you say Rahu, Kuru's Aquarius, he's in eighth. Not with, Venus. And again, this other lord Saturn is with Ketu in the second. So yeah, something to do with the mother, or maybe some relative sometimes, or it could be an issue. Mercury also can show relatives as ruling the 8th house. Now, of course, I did not inquire what was the family problem, because that was not a part of the discussion. But yes, this is, it's very easy if we can read the chart stepwise.
Right.
Because even if you tell the person that, yes, you will get, that itself is a big relief.
Right.
Then the person will be concerned, okay, when this can happen, that is fine. But if you see that indications are negative, you know, then what is the use of seeing when it will happen? Because it's anyways not going to happen. So can I stop the screen share?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, so that is from my side. So I'll just quickly summarize. So the first thing we check, the lord of the day.
Perfect.
House is it rules, as we saw in these three cases, for career, 6th house, marriage, 7th house. Marriage was like bang on, direct 7th house. And
higher studies.
Higher studies and part-time job, which is 11th house, 9th house. 11th house is not part-time job, by the way. It is even more than the 10th house, but in this case, it can show income. And then the placement of these three of the day lord, that will tell you to what extent the resources are available to fulfill the agenda. Like in case of marriage, we saw Venus was in debility and in the sixth in Virgo. So resources are not available. The person is finding faults with every proposal which is coming. He's like, oh, this is not there. That is not there. This is not good. That's not typical Virgo behavior. And that is why he's following celibacy. He's staying single because that's what is the sixth house. And then we saw the planets conjoined. The day lord is also very important. And the planets aspecting the ascendant or sitting in the ascendant will show to what extent are you optimistic. And the placement of the ascendant lord will tell you to what extent are you in anxiety or to what extent does it bother you if that happens or it doesn't.
Right.
What extent are you working towards it to make it happen actually? Or you are just sitting down there lazy? And if you have the birth time and if you see something already, then you can confirm it from the person. Right. That also works sometimes, I've seen.
Right.
So suppose for this person, his birth chart would be available and he would run a great period, dasha-wise. Then now, if this person is also supporting, that means he will get a very big job. Because the sixth house gives you a job which is like, okay, it's of your level, but you are not very happy doing that. The 10th house gives you managerial responsibility, which means it is a job which people will tell you, oh, he or she got a better job than what they deserve, apparently. And the 11th house is even three times more powerful than the 10th house. The 11th house, suppose, then people will be like, oh, wow, how did you get that? Can you tell us also? Yeah, and as per numerology, you can check. One is for Sun, two for Moon. So we checked in that case because it was 17 for that. So he got a job in a very good company. And because it was Moon, 20 was there for that marriage case. So therefore, the person was very emotional and he was very much in anxiety. And for the first case, it was 9. So it was Mars. So Mars was again linked to the career. So it was a very strong career question. So you can combine these things and you will finally come at a verdict. And by that you can know what could happen or later on you could see when that could happen.
Right.
That will be all from my side.
Right. Wonderful, wonderful. Very nice. Okay. We can wind up now. It's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, but we'll continue for our casual chat.
Yeah.
I'll stop it.
Thank you very much for the invitation and see you soon then.
Thank you, Babajit, for coming to my channel. Thanks a lot. It's always a delight having you. Thank you.